सदा उद्विग्न मनः कृष्ण दर्शने क्लिष्ट मानसः लौकिकं वैदिकं चापि कार्यं कुर्वन्नास्थया निरुद्धवचनो वाक्यं आवश्यकम् उदाहरान् मनसा भावयै नित्यं लीलाः सर्वाः क्रमागताः। Translation to Mool Shlok 1. He whose mind is always yearning to see Shri Krishna and His divinity, not out of material and personal ego and desire, but out of pure love for Him, does all worldly tasks, duties prescribed in the Vedas without any attachment or expectation. Translation to Shlok 2 says, such a devotee controls his sentences. His speech speaks only when utmost necessary, and in his mind and heart always experiences Shri Krishna sports as he performed them one after the other. Commentary by Shri Gopeshwarji. If a devotee appears before the Lord disheartened by failure in worldly affairs, it saddens Sri Nandanandan too. His displeasure definitely spells doom for material endeavors and distances one from his loving service too. Thus, one must never come in his service with dejection, but rejoice in seeing his lotus face. Vraj Bhaktas would enjoy serving him in Nandaraiji's house, and when he would leave and roam in forest grazing cows, they would sing his praises in Venu Geet and Yugal Geet. So should Vaishnavas rejoice in his loving service, be delighted when seva-related tasks are accomplished over worldly affairs, and when unable to enter the seva, sing his praises, long to meet him again in seva anavasar or anosar, the inability to do the seva. Shri Krishna's word is to abide by the prescriptions of the Vedas, and Shri Mahaprabhuji professes Pushtamargiya Vaishnavas to fulfill those as well as the duties of a householder as they engage themselves in seva. Thus, these tasks must be fulfilled well with indifference to avoid infamy and disrespect to Vedic duties. It is essential to control, maintain, and watch our speech, as the emotions contained within are so dynamic that they tend to flow out of unnecessary talking. Fundamentally speaking, unless it relates to Shri Krishna and His divinity, is forbidden. However, as the world demands, one cannot do without speaking often. Therefore, a very little must be spoken unless utmost necessary, and a devotee must always remain merged in seeing and serving Shri Murari in his mind, heart, and soul sequentially, as he wakes up in the morning in Mangala, is offered adornments in Shringar, grazes cows in Gwal, and so on, and at dusk rests in Shayan. Thus keep offering Manasi Seva revel in his sweet pastimes.